Welcome students.
In today's video, I am going to explain you about convection and radiation. Now you know that there are three methods for heat of transfer are conduction, convection and radiation. You already have learned about conduction in my previous video. Okay, now start with convection. Before telling you the definition of convection, I want to give you one example to explain it simply and to understand it. You have to see this picture. Here I am taking one half filled flask with water and adding some quantity of potassium permanganate. Why I am using potassium permanganate here? Yes, to show the movement of water. Now start. On hitting the water of bottom come in contact with heat, and because of heat it spread up and become light and rise upwards. Whereas cold water of the top being heavier and come down again, this cold water come in contact with heat and because of heat it again goes to upward. You can see this movement with the help of potassium permanganate because of color. In this way the entire water of this vessel becomes hot, and this process takes place till the entire water becomes hot, and this type of current moving between liquids and gases are called convectional currents. So students, in this vessel the entire water becomes hot because of the movement of water. So the method of heat transfer which takes place due to the motion of molecules is called convection. Now students, I have some question for you. Why we required windows or ventilators in our houses and factories? Yes, because in houses and factories smoke and heat air rise and escape through windows and ventilators. Tell me why? Because of this weight they are lighter, smoke are lighter than surrounding air, and that is why we required this. And another question, why we feel very warm when air from ceiling fan comes to us? Yes, it is also because of convection. Okay, I am explaining you. As warm air is lighter because of heat, it remains in the contact of upper part of the room, which is called ceiling. And this is the reason why the air from ceiling fan is warm. Now come to the next topic, radiation. Now students, before telling you radiation, I have one question for you. Look, if you are talking about sun and earth, earth is our planet which gets every day heat from the sun. How? Look, for conduction and convection, this both the methods are requiring one medium to transfer of heat. But in the space between sun and earth there is a vacuum. Then how it gets heat? This is called radiation. Students, so the method of heat transfer in which no medium is required is called radiation. And this, the amount of radiated heat depends on three things. First, temperature of the object, color of the object and nature of the object. And because of this, black color of surface is good absorber of heat, and that is why the bottom of cooking utensils are painted black so that they can absorb more heat. And because of this, we feel hot during summers and we feel cold during winters. These all are example of radiation. So students, the method of heat transfer in which no medium is required is called radiation. Thank you.